What's up guys, I'm Stavis, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to show you a quick hack that's going to have you playing two string arpeggios up and down the neck in no time. Now let's get into it. Alright, so in a previous lesson, which will be linked here, I discussed the formula on how to construct major, minor and diminished triads. We're going to be using that exact same formula today because arpeggio just describes a technique of how to perform something. So we're going to take our triads and we're going to arpeggiate them. Now arpeggio is an Italian word and it means to play the harp. And if you can imagine a harpist, what they do is they pluck each of the strings individually. So we're going to take an A major triad, so 5 on the low E, 4 on the A, 2 on the D. So that's A major. A, C sharp, E. Root, 3rd, 5th. Play them all together in harmony. So that's our chord. We can arpeggiate that triad by picking the notes individually. That's all there is to it. You'll definitely be familiar with it from rhythm playing. And when it comes to rhythm playing, you want the notes to ring out because it adds that nice, lush sound and it's got a lot of body and the notes ringing out in harmony sound really well. But when you're playing lead playing, you want to isolate each one of those notes so they don't bleed into each other because it can make your playing sound kind of muddy and sloppy. So you're after clarity. So because we're using triads and we're using two strings, there's two ways of playing these arpeggios. We're going to have either two low notes and one high note, or the ones we're looking at, which is going to be the root on the lower string and the third and the fifth on the string above. Now what that means is we've got six shapes in total. So three of the shapes are going to cover you for pretty much most of the neck. And the other three relate entirely to the G and the B string. They kind of throw a spanner in the works. So we'll get to them later. We're just going to focus on the other three for the moment. So if we take an A major triad, 5 on the low E, 4 on the A, which is our C sharp, our major third, and then 7, which is our E, our fifth. Root, third, fifth. That's our major triad. And that's our major arpeggio. If you remember a formula from before, to make major minor, you flatten the third. So we take this note, move down a semitone. So we end up with this. So that's minor. Major, minor. And to make our minor diminished, we flatten the fifth. So we take the seventh fret and we move down to the sixth. And those are the three shapes. Major, minor, diminished. And here's where this becomes really useful. You can traverse three octaves using the exact same shape just by moving up to the next octave. So we've got 5, 4, 7. If we start on the 7th fret of the D, which is an A, 6 is our C sharp, 9 is our E. Exact same pattern. If we start on this note, which is the, it's an A, it's the 10th fret of the B string, so 10, 9, 12, exact same pattern. So you can see you can cover quite a big distance with the exact same pattern. And that's where this becomes really useful and really easy to navigate the neck. And the exact same thing works for minor. And diminished. And you'll notice each of those notes rings out individually. I'm not getting. And how you execute that is by lifting your finger after each fret. When the note is done being played, lift your finger. Now you don't have to do that when you fret this because this is now in the way of that. And you don't want to be doing unnecessary movement. You just anchor that finger down there because you're going to be pulling off. Now you may remember from the previous lesson that the chord scale formula for a major key goes major, minor, minor, major, major, minor, diminished. And that the interval formula goes tone, tone, semitone, tone, 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 semitone. We're going to use those formula to navigate our way through the G major scale using our arpeggio shapes. We're going to start with the B string, so the 8th fret. So we've got 8, and then 7 on the high E, and then 10. So that's G major. G, D, D. We move up a tone to make our next shape, and our second chord is minor. So use our minor pattern. Our third chord is also minor, and it's a tone away. and we use the exact same shape. So 12, 10, 14. We move up a semitone to our 4 chord, which is major. So C major, 13, 12, 15. Up a tone to our D major, which is our 5 chord, so 15, 14, 17. Up a tone to our 6 chord, which is E minor, so 17, 15, 19. Up a tone to our 7 chord, which is diminished, F sharp diminished, so 19, 17, 20. And then back to our G major. So that's our G major. Now that exact same pattern, exact formula will be applied to a lower version of that. So if we go an octave lower, so we're starting on the 5th fret of our D string. So we've got G major. So 5, 4, 7. 7, 5, 9. 9, 7, 11. 9, 10, 12. And same if we even start on our low E. And we can use that to jump from one area of the neck to the other, so you're not moving linearly, you can move diagonally, and it helps make your playing more fluid and a little bit more creative, especially when you start to piece together where those arpeggios are coming from. So if we take G major, so root, third, fifth. Now around those notes, where they come from is the G major scale. So there's the 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 root. And the same if it was minor. Now, as I mentioned before, the G and the B string have their own unique arpeggio shapes. So we're going to start on the 12th fret of the G, 12th fret of the B, and then the 15th fret of the B. Now, what you'll notice you have to do here is what's called rolling. So you don't want the G and the B string ringing out together. So you do is you, once you fret the G and you're finished with the G, you roll off it, so you pivot off it, onto the B. And your finger still lightly touches that G string, so it kills the note. So if you're not familiar with that technique, I suggest you sit down and work on it, because it becomes quite important when it comes to playing full, like sweep picking. And same formula applies. So we flatten our third to get minor. So 12, 11, 15. That feels a little bit more natural because it's very similar to the major shape we play for the other strings. And then diminished, you move this down one fret. So you've got 12, 11, 14. And that feels very similar because it's the exact same shape as the major pattern we use for our other string. So major, minor, diminished. Now you can avoid those arpeggio shapes if you wish, but I do suggest you learn them because it's another piece of the fretboard puzzle that you can help to stitch the whole neck together. There are several ways to execute these arpeggios. You could do alternate picking, so we're going to take this G major triad. So we start on downstroke, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Each time you cycle the arpeggio and come back to the start, it's going to alternate either a downstroke or an upstroke. You could do economy picking, where you do two downstrokes followed by an upstroke. And something to watch out for if you've not tried that before and you're new to it is that because you're not going past the string and coming back to pick on an upstroke, you're going to hit that string sooner. So you're going to end up with kind of a lopsided sounding arpeggio. So the idea is to slow that down because you've got a gravity assist with it as well and control it. So you've got nice, even timed note. You could go inside picking, so where you pick in between the two strings you're using. So up, down, up, down. Sorry, up. So it's almost a reverse of the economy picking because you've got two upstrokes in there. You could pick outside the strings with that legato. So down, up, legato. Down, up, hammer. You could do hammer to pull off. So there's many different ways to do it. It depends what it is you're looking for in terms of sound. Like if you want something more percussive, you might want to throw some palm muting on it and pick every note. If you want something more fluid, you'll throw legato in it. Up next is a study piece that I've prepared. Now there are some technical challenging bits in it, but you can play it slowly on YouTube. The tab's going to be along the bottom of the screen. And what it does is it's used every shape that we have covered across the entirety of the neck. So we're going to go from way up here, right the way down to here. I've been real easy on you. I've only used the major, minor, and diminished arpeggio shapes for the G and the B. So I've only used the three shapes. I've not descended very far with them at all. They're just right here in this little area of the neck. So slow the video down, play it as slow as you need to. Focus on making sure each note rings out individually and you don't get note bleed, that your timing is even, that your dynamics are even, that you're in control of what it is you're doing. Well, there you have it. I hope you've enjoyed today's lesson. If you have, please hit that like button. And if you're new here, consider hitting that subscribe button. And don't forget to hit the notification bell so you never miss out on future content. I hope the exercise brings you more joy than it does frustration. And if there's anything you want me in future to cover in the videos, please let me know in the comments down below. If you're interested in Skype lessons, my contact details are also in the description box down below. Happy shredding. Thanks for watching and I'll see you on the next one.